All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Disney's Club Coca-Cola. How you doing? All right, thank you all for coming out. Welcome to Disney's. We've got a great show for you all tonight. Four incredible drummers coming to the stage. Before they do, just a couple of house rules. Take lots of photos, just no flash, no video. Please keep your conversations at the table to a quiet whisper. But if you hear something you like, make some noise, all right? Okay, good. Let's knock that right out. This is part of our Generations in Jazz Festival, where we feature some of the masters of our music, along with some up-and-coming leaders in our music. Tonight, we've got sitting in the audience the great Jimmy Heath. Put your hands together for Jimmy Heath, jazz master. Always happy to have him in the house. And I've got no more to say, because I want to see this show just as much as y'all do. So put your hands together for the whole drum truth. Welcome them to the stage, y'all. Thank you.
Well, we're going to take a break and let's talk a little bit now. And we have jokes. And we have awful things we can say. But because my brother and my sister-in-law and my attorney and his friend and a couple of my other friends are in here, I will not use the nasties. But when we step outside, I'm on my own. And I'll be very regular, and I will use the nasties. But see, you never know in a place like this who in here, if they don't use the nasties, like I have a couple of friends that don't use the nasties, and they always tell me that, like my brother always tells me, man, can't you say something else besides MFs and S's and all of them awful words? And when I call him, if his wife is out swimming, he gives me all the MFs and the nasty stuff. And he's sitting out here now, but he's 100, so he can say things like that. I'm almost 100, and my friend back here at the bar is 100. He's 92, and he tells me that's not 100. That is 100. He's back here, and he's, look at him back here screaming, how, I hope he doesn't take a drink, because he might disappear. You drinking water, right? Huh? Speak up, brother.
Sometimes wine.
Sometimes wine. That's 92. So you guys have hope, all you. Oh, 93. I left one off. Like that makes a difference. 92, 93. That makes a difference. It really doesn't. He is 100, and that's that. So, and my brother is 100. He's sitting out here somewhere. He's 88. That is 100. I'm 80. That's 100. Listen, 80, 90, 100. So, anyhow, hey, Jonathan, you laughing. You only 60 or something. You young guy. That's my attorney friend who is kind of the producer of this group. And he wouldn't miss one of these rehearsals or performances for anything in the world. He's the only guy that's not playing a drum that sits through our rehearsals from top to bottom, calls everybody, sends emails every 5 minutes. I'm so sick of him. He sends me emails every 5 minutes about who is going to be there, what's the equipment, this, that. Without him, this wouldn't have happened. But we want to say thank you to Jonathan Sanoff on the serious side. Jonathan, thanks. Because I couldn't pay you, but at least I can say thank you. Thank you too, Annie, for being his friend. All right, so that takes care of that. And if I have any enemies out here, get your money back from Lou Hayes. He's acting like he's not in it, but he is. Here's a guy here who I've been knowing since maybe 1958, we came to New York City around the same time. Lou came from Detroit, and I came from Philadelphia. And Lou always told me that, you know, Tootie, you're all right, but I think I have you made. So in other words, he always said he could play better than me, but I don't care, because I look better than him. I'm more handsome. And I always tell him that, so we don't care about that stuff. Because we got Cynthia over here that played better than all of us up here. And she's looking real cute over there and acting. Yeah, she's, what I call her, Cynthia? That's it, I'm calling you Cynthia from now on, that's it. I've been calling this woman Cynthia all week. Her name is Sylvia. This is old people stuff and I hope you forgive me. But I don't know what this is. This Sylvia business and the Cynthia business is too close to make a difference. And I keep calling her Sylvia when her name is Sylvia, and I keep calling her Cynthia. What's the difference? But every time I call her Cynthia, she does like this, puts her hand up. So I know I said it wrong. Joe just told me just now. But we have this gorgeous woman over here on my right, an excellent drummer that I keep calling the wrong name, and she puts up with it. Sylvia Quinker. And next to her is Joe Saylor with the cowboy hat on, who Joe thinks he's gonna be on television, but he don't know that the camera goes by real fast when you're on TV, but you go to the bank real slow. So I just told Joe, I went shopping with Joe. Joe bought some cute little tight-ass clothes and, uh-oh, I dropped the A-bomb. Slipped out, I'm sorry, Lou. But it slipped out. But Joe bought a bunch of little tight-ass clothes and he thinks the camera's gonna be on him on the TV show. But it ain't, what's the name of that television show? Cause Late Show. Y'all watch out for Joe Sale on the Late Show, because the camera's going to say, phew, right by him real quick. But he's going to be playing a whole lot of drums, and maybe they'll stay on him, because he plays a bunch of drums. And I'm pleased to have Joe Saylor as another one of these special people that are here in New York City that took out time to be up here with me in this nonsense. So Joe Saylor, Louis Hayes. The one and only Louis Hayes, Sylvia Quinca. Thank you. And our next selection is going to be, we're going to go and smoke a little crack, and we'll be right, no, I'm just joking. Our next song will be, see, this is old people stuff. I got a list up here, and I don't know what we just played, because all of them sound the same, you know, boom, bam, boom, bam. So it's kind of hard to differentiate. I know you people saying, damn, I wonder when they're going to take a break. We just did. So now we're going to do a shuffle. And a shuffle is an old African rhythm that Louis Hayes is kind of a shuffle master. He sits over here and he does some really wonderful stuff with the traditional shuffle. And Sylvia and Joe and I, we play our ideas of as kind of a, since they're younger than me, their ideas are a little younger. Mine are like damn near antique, but I learned it from an old guy, so it's still valid. But Lou Hayes plays the real shuffle, and we're gonna play our next piece now, which was arranged by Joe Saylor. I make him have the credit for this, just in case y'all hate this, don't think it's mine. Anything you hate up here is written by Sylvia. She's sitting over there laughing now, but it ain't gonna be funny when people start throwing tomatoes up here. All right, Lou, I quit. I ain't gonna announce this. This is a secret. Because we don't know what it is.
Thank you.
Sylvia Cuenca, ladies and gentlemen. How about that? Shortly. Like my brother said, that's the only way he can come back is shortly. And those of you who know Jimmy Heath, you know what shortly is. That's him.
Yeah. Let's say it one more time for the great Tootie Heath, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Saylor on the drums. Louis Hayes on the drums. Sylvia Cuenca on the drums. Thank you all for coming out. That's our first show. Good night.
All right. How's everybody doing? Make some noise. Make some noise, New York. How's everybody doing? This is a very special occasion, and it's part of our Generations of Jazz Festival, and tonight has been something we've been looking for some time. It was a lot of hard work, many phone calls, people getting cussed out on the phone by one of the people who you're gonna see on stage. He does a lot of cussing, but we're very honored. You must know what you see before you is a very unique thing because it includes two of the greatest drummers of our time, of our music, of all time. So I want you to first put your hands together for this incredible group that you're gonna see in front of you. The person that actually put a lot of it together is one of the great drummers of our music and musician, Mr. Albert Tootie Heath. Put your hands together first. Beside him is also one of the great drummers of our music. He's one of the great musicians that innovated the cymbal beat on many different levels. His name is Mr. Louis Sadell Hayes. Put your hands together. And joining them is Miss Sylvia Cuenca and Mr. Joseph Saylor. And we're gonna enjoy the whole drum truth. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen.
gonna let Joe Saylor have this mic because I say all the nasties and I get in trouble. Or I let Lou Hayes do it. He ain't gonna even talk. Look. Lou said if he get the mic, he get paid extra. But you know what? We need to just stop for a minute because I'm gonna give it to you though, Joe. We need to stop for a minute because I'm old up here and I get tired. Lou Hayes ain't gonna admit it. He's old too, but he ain't saying nothing. But he's glad when I take a break. Believe me, I know it. And Kenny Washington sitting out there, he's glad he ain't up here. But we all learned a lot from that brother. He's out here. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most fabulous drummers in this city of New York is Kenny Washington, my man. He's in the back. Take a bow, Kenny. Well-deserved educator and fabulous musician and a great human being. He takes all my harassment and never smacked me, never did nothing. You know, and I say some pretty awful stuff. And Lou Hayes don't hit me either, because he know I was stabbing. Because I got a reputation for stabbing people. And Lou knows about that, because he was here in New York in 1958 when I was cutting people up around here. So Joe Saylor, ladies and gentlemen, that's the newest member of the media, meaning the TV. Joe Saylor is on a TV show that I don't watch because I'm in the bed at night and I can't even remember the name of it. Plus, I don't live around here, so I don't know what he's talking about. But I know he's on TV and he's rehearsing a lot of the time during the day. I think the show starts when? Tuesday, the show starts. What's the guy's name? I'm sorry, Bill Cosby? Wait a minute. Oh, hold it. What's the guy's name? See, I can't even say that. Stephen Colbert. Joe Saylor. And then I have the fabulous over there who's not on television, Cynthia Quaker. She's the most gorgeous. I did it again. I keep calling her Cynthia, and her name is not Cynthia. What the hell I keep doing that for? Now I'm going to give the mic to Joe Saylor because I just fucked up.
I just want to say that it's an honor and a privilege for me to be sitting here on the stage with these two gentlemen to my left. I've been listening to them play since I was a little boy. And I first met Tootie about 10 years ago. I got to do an internship at Stanford University at the jazz camp, and Tootie was on the faculty. And they threw me in there as the intern faculty to teach drum classes with Mr. Heath. And we got into the first class, and I was 19 years old, and I didn't know what I was doing. And and we got in there, and he talked for about 5 minutes, and then it was an hour and a half class. And he talked for about 5 minutes, and then he said, "All right, you got it, Joe." And he walked out. And I had about 40 drummers from age 10 to 18 to work with for an hour and a half. But anyway, it's been a privilege to know him and as well as Mr. Hayes. And now I'll let Sylvia say a few words.
Thank you. It's a real honor, a thrill, and a pleasure to be sharing the stage with all these guys. especially these two, who are my drum heroes, and I've been listening to them since I was a very young little girl. And I met Tootie in California, same situation in Stanford, and I think he might have thrown a class of drummers on me, too. But it's an honor to be sharing the bandstand with these my heroes, and thank you for coming tonight.
Lou, you want to say something to these lovely people? I'm going to make you say something. I'm going to smack you in your mouth if you don't talk.
I was here a couple of nights ago with a group. I had a group here, and we said all we had to say musically that night. Some of you weren't here, but we had a marvelous time, and I was glad to do that. But I came to New York in 1956. Horace Silver asked me to come to New York. I was in Detroit, a youngster, and I was in his band for 3 years with Cannonball and Oscar Peterson. Had a lot of wonderful experiences here in New York, and I'll never leave. And this is a wonderful experience here tonight, being here with this, just looking at all these drums knock me out. And we're going to continue, we're going to carry on. And what are we going to do next, Tootie? We're going to play a shuffle, which is shuffle along. Now's the time, shuffle style.
But, you know, Lewis is a very modest young man, and for him to grab that mic and say something, that's like, whew, whew. You know, that's serious. Because Brother Man, you know, he's a very private person, which I love messing with him because he don't say nothing, see? Yeah, I can say all kinds of shit to him, and he don't say nothing. So he just look at me, you know. I know ain't no punch coming or nothing because he's a peaceful brother, but this guy, we came to New York around the same time, and around, he says he came in 56. I think he got here just a little bit. You must have been about 10, 9, 56. Damn, playing with Horace Silver when he was a baby. But I came in 58, and I had the awful pressure of taking Elvin Jones's place with not Dizzy Gillespie, but J.J. Johnson. And J.J. sent me a couple of albums with Elvin playing on them. And he said, yeah, listen to these, and we're going to start rehearsing next week. Man, I put the records on, and this guy was playing some of the most ridiculous drums I have ever heard in my life. Wasn't nothing that I was familiar with. His drum sound didn't sound like no drums I had ever heard. He was grunting all through the arrangements. And I said, well, how the hell am I going to replace this guy? Which I never did, but I came in and I did what I could do and kind of messed around with JJ for a few years because of that. And I got a chance to meet Lou Hayes. And we were on a few things, different bands on concerts together. And I got a chance to meet him and Roy Brooks and some other Detroit people, Frank Gant, that we're looking for Frank Gant. Lou asked me, where was Frank Gant? I asked him, where's Frank Gant? But we don't know where Frank Gant is. I think Frank Gant got a shopping cart out here somewhere. I really think so. I mean, I know you don't think so, but I think Frank is out here with a shopping cart laying on that cardboard on the sidewalk. Man, it's the truth. Yeah, I got to get off Frank because that might happen to me too, because after this, I don't know where I'm going after this. I might go to pieces after this. But I might have a shopping cart, and if I do, I won't come to New York because this is the worst place to be on the street in your life. When that wintertime hit around here, you don't want to have no shopping cart and have your ass out on these streets. It ain't no joke. I'm going back out where it's nice and warm, and my friend said I was raising rattlesnakes in Santa Fe, New Mexico. He said, what do you do out there, raise rattlesnakes? Where is he? Is he out here? Jonathan, are you here? No, he left. He got enough. Anyhow, that was enough rest. We rested up enough now. I think we can play a little bit more because I've run out of nasty stuff to say and I can't say nothing awful about nobody else. Except, ladies and gentlemen, my nephew's in the house back there and his wife and his family with his son and a couple of fine-ass ladies is with his wife and she knows who she is. And there's a couple people, he brought a party of about six people over here from Jersey, and I really appreciate it. My nephew, I stopped calling him to ask him to come to our performances with his father, Jimmy Heath, little short bastard. He just left. He just left. And he ain't here, so I can call him a little short bastard. But he just left. But anyhow, M. Tume Foreman is back there, ladies and gentlemen, from the 1980s, 90s hitman, Tombs. Stand up, take a bow, right now. Get up, Tombs, get up. Yeah, yeah. There he is back there. He got his family with him, so he got backup. He ain't getting up. But anyhow, I want you people to, man, good night. we like to play work song and feature our stellar drummer, Lou Hayes. He got some smooth stuff he's finna throw down over here for y'all. Here it comes.
Thank you.
Thank you, folks, on behalf of Sylvia Quinca, Joe Saylor, and the one and only Lewis Hayes. We'd like to thank you all for coming out and supporting our band with no instruments other than drums.
Yeah!
Thank you very much.
That's right, stand up. Albert Tootie Heath. Albert Tootie William Heath, ladies and gentlemen. Joseph Dwayne Saylor. Sylvia Quinco. Louis Hayes. Albert Tootie William Heath, put your hands together. Joe Saylor. Sylvia Quinco, put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. And we gotta say something. Stay. We have to say, when you leave here, when you go home tonight, I want you to write a letter to the NEA, and I want you to say that you want Louis Hayes and Albert Tootie Heath to be recognized, even though we recognize them as jazz masters, we want the whole world to know that they are jazz masters. And I want you to write, so when you go home, there it is. When you go home, write an email, write a letter to NEA, say that you were disgusted and appalled that these two incredible people that changed our music are not recognized. So put your hands together. Albert Tootie Heath, Louis Hayes. Louis Hayes, Albert Tootie Heath. That's right. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. And we also want to say a happy birthday to Michelle. Michelle, put your hands together. Happy birthday. And we have some more music coming up. There's a very wonderful vibraphone player called Joel Ross. Stick around if you want to hear some more music. Enjoy. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you.